And there's no question but those close contacts with Flo and her family were very important to my own development.
Documentary filmmaker Brent Morgan is like a modern-day archaeologist. He was approached by National Geographic Documentary Films to piece together a film of Dr. Jane Goodall in Tanzania in 1960. She was then exploring the chimpanzees, their behavior, first time in the wild. So, of course, he had a daunting task of taking over 150 hours of footage that was presumably lost and piece together one amazing journey. And he joins me right now. Brett, greetings from Las Vegas.
Hi, Jeff. How are you?
Now, Brett, you had to go through over 150 hours of footage. You didn't even know if the film even survived, the quality of the film. Nothing was cataloged. This was just a daunting task to tell a story and to catalog all of this footage. You were like, it sounds like you were like Indiana Jones discovering a lost city for the first time.
It really was. When we received the 140 hours of footage, it was essentially 140 hours of individual shots. And we, with no sound components to it, and we had to somehow figure out how to reconstruct that and make sense of it. Fortunately, we had Jane's book, In the Shadow of Man, as a kind of guide, and it allowed us to kind of look through the footage and try to find material that would help bring that story to life. Jeff, I have to say that my heart, as well as Jane, goes out to everyone in the Vegas community for all that you've had to go through the last few weeks. I was with Jane the night of the horrible ordeal that you all had there. And I will say, of everyone, I'm on a satellite tour right now. And if there was a place and a film that I think could bring some sort of healing and some hope, I really think this film, Jane, is a movie that in a world that is filled with so much darkness right now, is really a beacon of light. This woman really offers us so much hope. And anyway, I just wanted to share that with you.
Now, we know Dr. Jane Goodall, this was a groundbreaking scientific experiment to be among the chimpanzees, to observe their behavior. But this movie is much more than a wildlife movie, because there's also a love story with Dr. Jane Goodall and her cameraman. It's just, this movie has so many different levels to it.
Yeah, I think that audiences know about Jane's work. One of the things that truly excited me about this opportunity to make this film is it is a love story. And it's a love story that works on two levels. Part of it is that in 1962, National Geographic sent out a photographer to document Jane's findings. And the two of them fell in love. And they fall in love through the lens of the camera, which is kind of extraordinary. You literally are watching them fall in love on camera. It is also, though, a love story about a woman and her work. And that is a very powerful thing. You know, a lot of women in our society struggle with this idea of they have a dream that they want to pursue, and then they have a family. And oftentimes in our society, the woman is asked to give up her dreams and her career for the family. And in the case of Jane, she was able to not give up her career, to have a child. And in a way, we get this incredibly potent story of a woman who's able to kind of just live out her dreams, which is something I hope all young kids can experience.
And of course, the one question on everyone's mind, was it essential to get Dr. Jane Goodall's cooperation with this film?
You know, it's funny. It wasn't essential to get Jane's cooperation in the sense that we had this amazing footage. I was given final cut, and she's done countless interviews. But, I wouldn't say, a lot of times in my films, I think that I'm collaborating with the subjects. This was not a collaboration in that sense. She really wanted very little to do with me until she saw the film, and now she seems to be quite smitten.
Now, Brad, I've read somewhere that you discourage people from reading reviews of your films, that you prefer they go in cold. They have no idea if it's good or bad.
Oh, you know, listen, I think that everyone should walk into a movie with as little information as possible. I think it's, especially a film like Jane. Jane really transports you to Africa in the early 60s in a way that we've never seen before. And but I think that if you have a deep knowledge of Jane, or you have a superficial knowledge of Jane, this film will show you and excite you and thrill you in a way that few films will this year.
Brett, you did an amazing job. I think Jane's one of the most amazing documentaries I've ever seen. And not only that, it's just perfect for National Geographic documentary films, because you just It's like discovering a lost city. It's such an amazing find. You did a wonderful job. Thank you so much for speaking to me today, and come visit us in Las Vegas real soon.
Thank you, Jeff.
All right, for more reviews and interviews, just surf on over to my website at vegasfilmcritic.com. Also, check me out on social media. I'm on Twitter. I'm on Instagram. I'm on Facebook. I'd love to hear from you. Also, if you're watching on YouTube, make sure you give me a thumbs up. Subscribe button is really cool if you want to not miss any of my movie reviews and interviews. And also, take me along over on iTunes. My podcast is available 24/7. I'm Jeffrey K. Howard in Las Vegas. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you next time.